So today, I thought we'd take a look at the most popular weapons in Battlefield 1 in terms of their total percentage from the class they're in. Essentially, that means which weapon gets the most kills every day within each class. Now, this data is taken from Battlefield Tracker. A link to their website is down in the description. It's a really informative website, by the way. Got so many more stats on it than the Battlefield Companion app's got. And the data I'm about to show you includes PC, PS4, and Xbox One values, accurate to the 15th of May 2017, one day before I'm making this video. You'll also be able to see lots of data for the days before the most up-to-date day, and we'll look at some of those peaks and some of those changes, but what I want to look at most is what's most popular right now. Starting off with the assault class then, we need to look at two different types of weapons here, the shotguns and then the automatic weapons, the carbines and the SMGs. As the weapons themselves are so vastly different, I think they deserve their own insight, and you'll see why I think that in just a moment. Those automatic weapons first of all then, the carbines and the SMGs. Well, I think you can see the clear win for the Hellregal 1915 factory. A rather sharp upturn as well a couple of weeks ago. I wonder why that might be. Oh yeah, the brand new Hellregal 15 defensive variant that required you to get 300 kills with the factory variant as part of the unlock process. So of course, the whole Battlefield community flocks over to the Hellregal factory and uses it to get more kills towards the Hellregal defensive, and that in turn increases the percentage of kills that the Hellregal gets until everyone's unlocked the new variant. But you can also see that the Hellregal has had the lead for some time before that, after people unlocking it through the rank 10 process for the assault class. Before that though, it was the MP18 Trench, which was the starter weapon for the assault class. Now as a reference, the brand new Ribeirol's factory variant added with the French DLC had a good surge initially, up to around 5% of total kills, and that's interesting considering that only premium members can use it, but it's taken a hit very recently with everyone moving back to the Hellregal factory to unlock that new variant. And interestingly, the new Hellregal variant, the defensive, having only been out for a couple of weeks, already brings in a higher percentage of total kills than the MP18 Experimental, which has been in the game since day one. Clearly not a very popular weapon. And for the shotguns, well, this is frankly embarrassing. I think we all knew the answer anyway, but by far and away the most popular is the Model 10A Hunter, with nearly 75% of all kills with shotguns every single day being registered by it. That's just absolutely mental. People complain that Battlefield 1 doesn't have enough content or doesn't have enough weapons, but this graph clearly shows that most people aren't even bothering to use the other shotguns and the other variants that are available. I guess you could argue that the Model 10A Hunter is still just too good in comparison to every other shotgun in the game, but stats don't lie. People want more content, and they aren't even using the content that's already in the game. Moving on to the Medic class now, and overall I think you're going to see something different to the previous graphs for the shotguns and the SMGs. Overall, the clear popular choice is the M1907 Sweeper variant, which again saw a sharp spike up in March when it was included in a weapon assignment to unlock one of the new RSC 1917 variants that was added in the French DLC. Right now, it's accounting for roughly 22% of all kills with the Medic class each day, which is nowhere near as high as the Model 10A shotgun in the previous graph. We're seeing a much nicer distribution overall, with lots of weapons getting kills across the board, but there's still this small group that's getting more use than others. The Selbstlader 1916 Optical and Marksman are up there at the top, the Autoloading 8 Extended and the Mondragon Storm are still the most popular choices, and have remained so really pretty much since the launch of the game. Next up we have the Support class, and this one will be very interesting because during the Battlefield 1 beta, this was the class that had the least amount of usage overall, and therefore you would think had the least amount of kills throughout the entire game, for a class anyway. Lots of people still think the LMGs need a bit more variation in their damage stats. All but one of them have a max damage of 23, but it's the stats underneath that change how the weapons perform. But here again we have a clear winner. Despite the recent additions such as the new Hewitt Optical Level 10 weapon and the Shoshar variants as well that came out in March, the BAR Storm is still leading the pack, taking home just under 30% of all kills with LMGs every single day. Now this chart might look vaguely similar to the shotgun chart, with one weapon at the top and all the other weapons down at the bottom, but all the LMGs are still getting a better proportion of the total kills because the highest percentage of those kills is only 30, with the other 70% being shared out among all of the others. So even though the chart looks the same, because the values aren't as high, you're getting a better proportion overall. And interestingly, the Shoshar low weight comes in at around 5% of the total kills at the moment, and that means it's one of the most popular new weapons that's been added to Battlefield 1 so far. And now the last of the four main classes with the Scout, but not the last group of weapons we're going to be looking at today. This is an interesting one, especially for the amount of changes that are on it. Now, three lines dominate this chart. The Martini Henry Infantry, the SMLE Marksman, and the Russian 1895 Sniper. At the launch of the game, the SMLE had a clear win because it was the starter weapon for the class, but that was quickly drained away within a month due to the rise of the pre-patch Martini Henry. Those were the days, eh? Now you can see a sharp decline with the Martini once it was nerfed and the SMLE Marksman taking back first position until recently when the Martini Sniper was introduced and lots of players jumped back to using the Martini Infantry to unlock that new variant. So there is a good distribution amongst all of these rifles here, with actually all of them being fairly close together in terms of their total kills per day. And that for me shows a fairly well-balanced set of weapons within the Scout class. And lastly, I wanted to take a look at the sidearms of Battlefield 1. Now don't forget, we have some class-specific sidearms here, so I don't expect those to be at the top of the list. Oh wait, I was wrong. The Mars Automatic is up in second place, being a Scout-only sidearm. That shows you how popular the Scout class really is in Battlefield 1. The M1911 still leads the way, as it has done pretty much since the launch of the game, with most other pistols accounting for less than 10% of total kills each day for sidearms. Now for reference, the Doughboy 1911, which came out with the Collector's Edition, the most expensive version of Battlefield 1, predictably sits at the bottom of the chart with only 0.2% of total kills every day, but the Hellfighter one does pretty well. And looking at the data from day one of Battlefield 1, the day it released, it had at one point nearly 20% of total kills for all sidearms. It's really interesting to look at all of that data, especially when you look at the start of Battlefield 1's life cycle, and then you compare it to where we are now. You can see some clear changes over the past few months, especially with the Martini Henry and the rollercoaster ride that that weapon's been on, with all of its buffs and all of its nerfs. And because all these stats are taken from Battlefield 1, we can be confident that they give a good representation of the daily habits of players. And it's clear right now that some weapons are getting the lion's share of kills. Predictably though, what happens is DICE will come along and balance those in a patch, and all of these popular weapons will suddenly be different to what they were before, and that's to try and encourage players to play with different things and adopt different playstyles. But most people will just complain that their favourite weapon isn't very good anymore. I mean, I think a really cool experiment would be to delete the Model 10A Hunter from Battlefield 1, the shotgun that gets 75% of all kills every day for shotguns, and then just see what the community do, see which weapons they gravitate to, whether the SMGs get more action, or if a different shotgun will start to get more kills than it did before. I think that would be a really cool experiment, but DICE are stuck in between a rock and a hard place, whatever they do, because if they try and balance something differently to what it was before, you're always going to get people complaining that their favourite weapon is no longer any good. Maybe I'll do another video like this soon, maybe after the summer, and have a look at the data again. Let me know down in the comments if you'd like to see that, because player habits might change over the summer. More players might come in, some older players might not play the game anymore, and we might have a different crop within the community, and we can have a look and see which weapons are popular then, especially after the Russian DLC drops. Anyway, thanks very much for watching. This video was really fun to make, and it was actually really interesting to look at the data, so I hope you all enjoyed it out there. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.